In the last class, we discussed about basic and basic buffer solution. Now let's take how to solve the problems based on that buffer solution problems. And the formulas we have derived in the last class for acidic buffer solution, pH is equals to pKa plus log of concentration of conjugated base by concentration of acid. And for basic buffer solution, pOH is equals to pKb plus log of concentration of conjugated acid by concentration of the base. And further for pH, we have to do 14 minus pOH. So let's take one simple question for the calculation of to identify the acidic buffer solutions, basic buffer solutions and a calculation of them. So question is, which of the following is buffer solution? Which of the following is buffer solution? So option A is given, 50 ml of 0.2 molar acidic acid plus 50 ml of 0.4 molar NaOH and 50 ml of 0.2 molar HCl plus 50 ml of 0.4 molar NaOH and 50 ml of 0.4 molar acetic acid plus 50 ml of 0.2 molar NaOH and the last one is none of the above. Right. So how to find which is the buffer? Already we have discussed that buffer is a solution having conjugate weak acid and conjugated base, or weak base conjugated acid will be called as a buffer solution. So now in this calculation, each solution we should take in between them reaction. So first A we check out, but before going to that one point we take, we convert them into milli equivalents. So here first question is given, reaction option A is given, reaction between the acidic acid and sodium hydroxide leads to formation of sodium acetate plus water. So option A solution, if you look at option A, whether it may act or not, let's see. So option A has given 50 ml of 0.2 molar acidic acid. Its milli equivalence, if you take initially the number of milli equivalents of the acidic acid becomes 50 into 0.2, that is 5 milliequivalents. I'm sorry, 10 milliequivalents. And sodium hydroxide milliequivalents, 50 into 0.4, it becomes 20 milliequivalents. Normally, when you use the milliequivalent concept, normality, the acids and base, whatever they react with 1 is to 1 ratio. So they react 10 and it is also react 10. Finally, it becomes 0 and NaOH will be 10. And sodium acetate, initially 0, reacted nothing, we have 10. So when end of the reaction, if you come, final end of the reaction, weak acid present 0. Strong base present 10 and the salt of the weak acid present 10 milliequivalents. It is present milliequivalents. Normally to act as a buffer, we supposed to have weak acid and conjugated base. So you have a weak acid, but end of the reaction, weak acid is 0 and we have the conjugated base. But weak acid is not present, so it cannot act as a buffer. So this is wrong. Next take option B. Option B has given 50 ml of 0.2 HCl, 50 ml of 0.4 NaOH. Actually, it is a strong acid and strong base. So, strong acid and strong base solution cannot act as a buffer. Only weak acid plus its conjugated base, or weak base and its conjugated acid can act as a buffers. So, option B, both are stronger. This solution cannot act as a buffer. And let's take the C option. So, C option solution, if you see here, option C, acidic acid is taken and as well as sodium hydroxide taken. Acidic acid concentration 50 ml 0.4 molar. So if you look at its milli equivalence calculation once again. So the milli equivalence calculation, if you take initially for acidic acid, 50 plus 0.4, that is 20 milli equivalents are present. NaOH 50 into 0.2, it is present 10 milliequivalents and they react in 1 is to 1 ratio. So 10 reacted, finally you will have 10 milli equivalents of acetic acid, 0 milli equivalents of sodium hydroxide and 10 milli equivalents of sodium acetate. So end of the reaction, we have weak acid is remain and conjugated base of the weak acid is remain, that is acetate ion. So this solution can act as a buffer. It acts as a buffer. Same way, look at one more question. One more question. Let's take one more question, right? Calculate pH of 50 ml 0.1 molar ammonium hydroxide and 50 ml 0.05 molar HCl solution. So calculate the pH of 50 ml of 0.1 molar ammonium hydroxide and 50 ml of 0.05 molar of HCl solution. So he is not given any conjugated base. So first of all, we make acid base reaction. So before going to that, we calculate constant milli equivalence of each one. So ammonium hydroxide milli equivalence. Milli equivalence of ammonium hydroxide is equals to 50 into 0.1, that is equals to 5. And number of milli equivalence of HCl. Milli equivalence of HCl is equals to 50 into 0.05, that is equals to 2.5. Now make the reaction between them. Ammonium hydroxide reacting with HCl, it leads to formation of ammonium chloride plus H2O. So initial number of milli equivalents of ammonium hydroxide 5, HCl milli equivalents are 2.5, ammonium chloride 0, and the reacted, they react in 1:1 ratio, so that is 2.5 reactor, and end of the reaction finally ammonium hydroxide will be present 2.5 and HCl will be present 0, ammonium chloride will be coming as a 2.5. So in order here finally remaining weak base remain and as well as its conjugated acid pair is remain. So pH formula, it is a basic buffer solution, weak base plus its conjugated acid. So this becomes a basic buffer solution. So in case of basic buffer solution, POH is equals to PKB plus log of concentration of conjugated acid by concentration of base. So here concentration of the base present 2.5, concentration of acid conjugated acid present 2.5, they present in 1:1 ratio, so that POH is equals to PKB and the pH equals to 14 minus PKB. If the PKB value is given, we can find what is the its pH of the solution. Simple. So PKB value is not given. If you want, you can assume. For example, PKB is equals to 2.5, I have mentioned in the question. So in order, what is the pH of the solution becomes 14 minus 2.5, that is equals to 11.5 is the answer for the pH of this basic solution. Same way, let's take one more question, sir. One simple question. One more. One more question, take. Question, right? If a solution contain 0.1 molar acetic acid, 0.1 molar acetic acid and 0.2 molar sodium acetate Ka equals to 2 into 10 power minus 5 for acid. Calculate pH of solution. Right? So, if a solution is taken, a mixture of solution is containing 0.1 molar acetic acid and 0.2 molar sodium acetate, Ka is equals to 2. So, solution K of this acid is given 2.10 power minus 5 for acid, and calculate the pH of the solution. So, here in the solution, we have weak acid present, and as well as its conjugated base also present, that is sodium acetate. So, obviously the question is belong to buffer solution. So, concentration of this one is given 0.1, and concentration of conjugated base is given 0.2. So, calculation formula we know, that is for acidic buffer solution, pH equals to pKa plus log of concentration of conjugated base by concentration of acid. But in the question, instead of giving pKa value, he has given only Ka value. So, concentration of conjugated base we know, concentration of acid also we know. To calculate pH, we need pKa. So, for pKa purpose, he has given Ka value. So, first of all, we have to calculate pKa from the Ka. So, pKa is equals to minus log of Ka. So, that is equals to minus log of 2 into 10 power minus 5. This we can write as 5 log, minus log 2 plus 5 can be written. So, minus log 2 value we know, that is 0.3010 plus 5 is equals to 4.64 is the pKa value of the acid. Since now we know the pKa value, this pKa value we substitute in the equation. So, pH is equals to 4.64 plus log of concentration of conjugated base. Concentration of conjugated base is given 0.2 by concentration of acid is given 0.1. So, that becomes pH equals to 4.64 plus this is log of 2 into 10 power minus 1 by 10 power minus 1 can be written. So, now it becomes 10 power minus 1, 10 power plus 1 becomes here cancelled, then log 2. So, pH is equal to 4.64 plus log 2. Log 2 value is 0.3010, that is equals to 4.941 is the pH of the solution. This is one kind of question for the calculation of pH. And still two more are there. So, that's let's take for one more pattern. So, this question based on the common ion effect. So, even common ion can make the change in the pH of the solution. So, let's come for one more question for the calculation of pH. This is the last but one method. Later, we can go with the last one. Right. Question, right, sir? Question is 0.4 molar HX. It's a weaker acid. HX and 0.8 molar NaX, which is a conjugated base of the acid, are mixed. In 1 liter solution, in 1 liter to form buffer. Ka equals to 10 power minus 4. Question number 1, find pH of solution. Question number 2, find pH of resultant solution if 0.2 molar HCl added. If 0.2 molar HCl added. And third question is find pH of resultant solution if 0.2 molar NaOH added. So now the question is calculation of pH on the addition of acid and as well as the base. So three cases questions are given, very important one. So first we solve. First one is asking find the pH. The given solution, however, it is clear HX is a one weak acid and its conjugated base is NaX present. So they mix it, it is acidic buffer weaken. So acidic buffer solution pH we know. So pH calculation purpose we need formula. pH is equals to pKa plus log of concentration of conjugated acid, I'm sorry, conjugated base by concentration of acid will be taken. So we need pKa, but he has given Ka. So pKa is equals to minus log of Ka, that is equals to minus log of 10 power minus 4, that is a 4. So here pH is equals to pKa, that is 4, plus log of concentration of conjugated base. So conjugated base concentration in the question itself is given 0.8 by concentration of acid, weak acid 0.4, that is pH is equal to 4 plus log of 2, that is pH is equals to 4.30. This is question number 1. Now question number 2, if you take, there is a reaction between present. Already we have discussed how the buffer solutions will retain the pH. Sometimes undissociated weaker acid or weaker bases are retaining the pH, and certain times when acid or base is added, dissociated conjugated acid pair or the conjugated base pair based on the buffer solution, they're retaining the pH. So let's take here, second question is given, find the pH of the resultant solution if the 0.2 molar HCl is added. So acidic buffer solution HCl is going to react with conjugated acid pair which is present. I'm sorry, conjugated base which is present in a solution, that is NaX, right? So because pH will be retained by the conjugated base pair but not by the Na acid, undissociated. So conjugated base pair will react with additionally added H plus ions to retain the pH. So let's take the reaction between that. So NaX react with added HCl leads to formation of NaCl plus HX. Now, if it is the reaction which takes place. So before that, we have to identify what is the concentrations are present initially. Already in a solution, NaX we have 0.8 present in the given solution as the data. Now HCl we are adding, which is equals to 0.2 molar we are adding. So when they react, they forms NaCl. Since initially reaction not has started, NaCl will be 0. And HX is a weak acid which is present in the solution, that is 0.4 already exists in the solution apart from additionally forms with the reaction between these two. Now they react in 1:1 ratio. So 0.2 moles of NaX react with 0.2 moles of HCl to form its respective products. So in order, finally NaX becomes 0.6, HCl will be 0, NaCl will be 0.2, and HX will become forming from here already. HCl reacting with this forming HX. So their combination ratio 1:1:1:1. So if it is 0.2 reacted, it forms 0.2. So existing 0.4 additionally formed 0.2, total becomes 0.6. This 0.6 we can write 0.4 plus 0.2. Already existing 0.4, now additionally formed 0.2, 0.6 became. So here NaX present 0.6 and HX also present 0.6 and their 1:1 ratio present. So pH is equals to pKa plus concentration of conjugated base, that is 0.6, conjugated acid also 0.6. So the ratio becomes 1:1 ratio. So the pH is equals to pKa. So that is nothing but equals to 4. So change has come in the pH, but initial pH is 4.30. Now it became as a 4. Now come to the number 3. Third question. So third question, he is added little amount of base added, that is NaOH added, which is 0.2 molar. So base added that react with acid. So now the reaction for third question, you have to make a reaction between acid present in the buffer solution HX and added NaOH react with this. So it leads to formation of NaX plus H2O. So in the solution, already we have the HX which is 0.4 and NaOH additionally we are adding 0.2 and NaX present 0.8, it is nothing. Next, react in 1:1 ratio. So 0.2, 0.2, it won't react anything. And finally, it comes 0.2, it will be present 0, NaX, their formation out is present, 1:1 ratio. So already 0.8 existing in the solution, additionally 0.2 is going to form, so here it total becomes 1. So the pH calculation purpose, pH is equal to pKa plus log of concentration of conjugated base, that is NaX. So NaX is equals to 1 became. And conjugate acid pair you have 0.2 is present and its pH calculation. Further you can proceed. So pH is equal to pKa value we got already in the previous question, 4 plus log of, it can be written 1/2 × 10⁻¹. So that will take pH is equals to 4 plus 1/2 means we can write as a 0.5. So that becomes a log of 5. Log of 5 into 10⁻². Log 5. So pH is equals to 4 plus log 5 value you enter, that is the answer. Right. These are the problems based on the buffer solution.